first time in more than four decades, Elkhart High Schools could combine. New at 11, it's just one of many ways the district is looking to restructure. WSBT 22's Danielle Kennedy is here now. Danielle, superintendent and the school board need the public's opinion.
Rick, they will decide if and how the restructuring happens. This is all part of the district's five-year plan, which includes possibly combining high schools and turning some elementary schools into K through 8s.
And if they are, then they'll go into...
Elkhart's school board approved six public hearings for the month of June to discuss the possible restructuring of schools in the district.
We're asking community folks, come out, be a part of that. Be a part of that discussion. Help frame what Elkhart Community Schools is going to look like for the next 10 years.
Administrators will begin meeting with school staff on Monday to discuss plans to possibly make elementary schools in the district K through 8 and combine Elkhart Memorial and Elkhart Central into one high school.
People are, they're going to be surprised by how much more they're able to do and their relationships to the people. I think it's really a good opportunity.
Gordon Compton remembers when the high schools were separated in 1972.
Yeah, they're competitive when they're on the field and on the court, but I still hang out with some Central kids and there's no bad blood. I'd like to come back and watch the last Mangy games, but it'd be pretty cool seeing the school actually dominate in sports, because I think that's what's going to happen when they merge the schools together.
School administrators say the plan calls to make Elkhart Central the ninth grade school, and 10th through 12th graders would go to Memorial.
But if it was Elkhart High School, there'd be more competition for the students to shine bright.
But that's a decision Superintendent Hayworth says the public will have to make.
For it to work, for anything that we would want to have started in our district, community support's crucial.
Even if everything in the plan was approved, changes wouldn't happen for several years. The superintendent says restructuring could cost about $33 million, but it will mainly be funded by the district's capital project fund and debt service fund. Wick, we have a copy of the district's plans plus a list of dates and locations for the public hearings posted on our WSBT 22 mobile app. Just click on this story.